Well, this could make you feel not so young. The CBS soap opera The Young and the Restless turns 40 today. John Blackstone talks to cast members who have been there for nearly all of it.
The theme might be familiar. Not only the music that has opened The Young and the Restless since March of 1973 until today, but the litany of marriages, divorces, betrayals, and reconciliations contained in more than 10,000 episodes over the past 40 years.
You're my past, my future.
What makes a show successful? That's so hard to say. The mysterious something, chemistry, whatever you call it.
I want you to show me your real feelings.
The show has featured one of the most popular on-again, off-again romances in daytime TV history. In 1981, when Eric Braeden's Victor met Nikki, played by Melody Thomas Scott, his character was a millionaire mogul and hers was a stripper. Victor and Nikki got married for the fourth time last week.
Eric and I have worked together now 33 years. Which is longer than a lot of marriages in real life.
I love you right here.
Victor and Nikki have endured for decades now, and their recent remarriage is just a terrific gift to the fans.
The Young and the Restless was also the first soap to go in depth with controversial storylines, like alcoholism.
The creator of our show, Bill Bell Sr. and Lee Philip Bell, they were always wonderful about bringing topical pieces to the show.
What the hell is going on here?
But the show was also not afraid once in a while to go off the deep end.
I actually liked the storyline, but it is crazy, is when I played Sheila.
Put the shank down, Sheila.
She changed her face to look like Phyllis, my character. And, you know, of course, that can't happen.
When you think about it, The Young and the Restless premiered when Richard Nixon was president, but people don't think of it in those terms. They just think of it as something that's always been in their lives.
With any luck, we'll still be watching Y&R in 2053 for the show's 80th anniversary. For CBS This Morning, John Blackstone, San Francisco.
Fans are very devoted.
Soap operas, they love them, don't they?
I was going to say, the fans are very devoted to it. When so many have come and gone, 40 years later, it's still going strong.
And a young friend of mine, William Gray Espy, played the original Foster on The Young and the Restless. Now lives in Alabama.